In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful. This is a book which we have revealed to you, O Muhammad, in order that you might lead mankind out of the darkness of disbelief and polytheism, and into the light of belief in the oneness of Allah by their Lord's leave, to the path of the Almighty, the Owner of all praise.
The Quran is one of the most unique and remarkable books mankind has ever known. The whole Islamic religion is based upon this one book. The Quran is considered as the direct speech of God, which was later recorded in written format. It is the last and final message God has sent for the whole of mankind. So in order to live up to this unique status, it must contain some exceptional information. What does the Quran make so unique? And how do we know it's from God? One of the greatest mysteries of modern science in general, and evolutionary biology in particular, is regarding the origins of human language.
Language is probably the hardest problem in science. Nobody really knows how it works, and nobody really knows where it came from. And yet we can all do it. I think it's a bit like driving a car. We can drive a car, but we don't really know how the machine works.
Noam Chomsky, one of the greatest political commentators alive, but whose actual expertise is linguistics, claims that the only way to explain language is not via the typical means of evolutionary biology, where incremental mutations occur and a trait gradually evolves.
Mutation happened in one individual. From there, it spread to all other people and eventually created all the languages of the world.
Since there are no other species of animals that even come close to our ability to speak, it is clear that humans are atypical in this gift. And something must have happened in us that didn't happen in any other animal.
One of the things that makes language unique, I think, is that we can generate new sentences all the time. There's an infinite capacity to say something different. Animal language, or animal communication, on the other hand, is mostly repetitive, automatic, and emotional, and doesn't create new meanings.
Another world-famous psychologist, Steven Pinker, has done groundbreaking research in children's acquisition of languages, and argues that languages are innate in humans, without really explaining how this innateness came about.
How can there be so many languages, each of them impenetrable to all of the others? Any child, though, can learn any one of those languages, provided they start early enough. So that's a paradox. Any kid can learn any one of them, yet most of us only learned one or two of them.
What is truly fascinating in all of this is that the one gift that the Quran explicitly mentions as having been divinely bestowed on Adam is that of language. And the Quran says,
وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِلْعَالِمِينَ
Allah mentions the blessings He has given to mankind.
الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان
Language cannot be explained by modern science, because it was a divine gift bestowed on us, and only us, from between all of the creation.
How are we to solve that problem? The common solution is that language is a miracle. A miraculous thing that happened all at once.